Farm Series Part 1. Alabama farmers will tell you they're proud to be Americans, but they'll also tell you being a farmer in America today isn't easy.
Come to Jesus, be our guest, and that's what you've given us. Amen.
The Larry McCord family gets up early in the morning. After breakfast, it's time for the morning chores. The whole family pitches in. The hired farmhands that used to help are gone. So are a lot of the luxuries the McCords used to enjoy. Now the family is just trying to survive.
Well, this year we won't be borrowing any money. We kind of operating off ourselves. I had an insurance policy and I borrowed on it. So that's what I'm going to operate on this year.
A few years ago, John Swearingen also had hired help on the farm. Today, Swearingen relies totally on his family and is farming fewer acres.
Sure, it's been rough. It really has. And we work long hours. We work hard and we work long hours, and we've got a lot of investments.
Yes, rural Alabama will tell you there's a crisis on the family farm, and sadly, statistics will back them up. A survey of 1,500 Alabama farmers taken by Auburn University last year reveals some frightening numbers. The average total debt for the farmers responding to the survey was more than $70,000. 23% of the farmers said they were behind in either interest or principal payments on farm loans. 11% said they had been turned down for a loan in the past year. And an alarmingly large number of farmers expected to leave the profession in the future. 38% said they would likely leave farming in the next 5 years. Are Alabama farmers really in bad shape? Well, that depends on who you ask. Some are better off than others. But more and more, the full-time traditional farm family is becoming a thing of the past. Tomorrow night, we'll look at how the farm family is surviving. Surprisingly, not all of the family's income is coming from the land. Carrie Gordon, WSFA TV News. Farm Series Part 2. Living on the farm has never been easy, but farm families say lately making a living off the land is getting harder. Ramona McCord used to spend all her time on the family farm, working side by side with her husband Larry. But last July, things changed. Ramona had to find a job off the farm to make ends meet. The mother of four says one event triggered the decision.
On Christmas Day of '83, I didn't have the money to buy groceries to buy Christmas dinner. And I promised my family that day that I would never let that happen again, if I could do anything about it.
But the McCords aren't the only ones being forced to look for additional income away from the farm. John Swearingen from Pike Road supplements his farming by selling crop insurance. With a real estate license, the third generation farmer also appraises and sells farmland. Yes, times have changed on the farm. In addition to relying more on outside income, farmers are planting fewer crops. The Alabama Crop and Livestock Reporting Service says four of the state's major row crops are down at least 3% from last year. Possibly one of the biggest drops has been in soybeans. Once one of the state's most popular crops, soybean planting is down 21%. Alabama Farm Bureau says farmers started losing money on soybeans when the crop was overplanted. Today, most farmers can't produce enough beans to make a profit. But that theory could be accurately applied to agriculture across the board.
What is the solution for agriculture? Profit. Simply that. Make agriculture profitable. It is not profitable today.
Yet low market prices are only part of the problem. In the 70s, farmers were encouraged to expand, to borrow more money to grow more food. Today, many farmers say there's too much food on the market, and they're paying back loans at high interest rates, which take a big chunk out of their budget. Another problem is on the foreign market. American farmers are not only competing with more farmers around the world, they're competing with farmers who are heavily subsidized by their own foreign governments. and the high value of the U.S. dollar overseas makes matters worse.
We can't compete with a foreign government and the foreign farmers. We'd like to compete with the foreign farmers because we can do it well.
Another big problem facing farmers is that many of them owe a lot of money, with much of that credit coming from the federal government. But have those federal dollars been a curse or a blessing? We'll ask that question tomorrow night. Carrie Gordon, WSFA TV News. Farm Series Part 3.
We're still the only lender that I'm aware of in the state of Alabama that'll loan money to a farmer that has a negative net worth or a minus net worth, where his liabilities exceed his assets.
1985 marks 50 years for the Farmers Home Administration. The federal program has already lent more than $67 million to Alabama farmers this year. But there comes a point when even the federal government has to say no.
It's no easier being in agriculture lending than it is being in agriculture, because on each side of the table there are some difficult decisions that have to be reached.
Farmer Larry McCord had to borrow money from an insurance policy to keep his farm going this year.
Are you scared for your farm?
Farmers Home Administration has been good to us, so I don't know how long, you know, we hope we work things out.
It is estimated that at least 20% of the state's farmers are behind in their farm loan payments. With this much of the rural community already delinquent, should the federal government offer more financial help?
More credit is not the solution to our problem. We got to get a better price for our product. We already owe too much money already.
The farmer don't want the help from federal government, but he hasn't got any choice. So.
But with some farmers going deeper in debt each year, should they just get out of farming? Has the availability of federal dollars kept poor businessmen in agriculture?
With the number of applicants that we have, there may be people who should not be in agriculture.
A lot of people were farming that really shouldn't have been farming. And we still got a lot of people farming that really shouldn't be farming.
By and large, the majority of agriculture feels like that, yes, there are some farmers should be allowed to go broke.
Most farmers agree borrowing more federal money is not the solution, as going deeper in debt will not guarantee them a profit. But farmers are looking to Washington for answers. And tomorrow night, we'll look at what Washington has in mind. Carrie Gordon, WSFA TV News. Farm Series Part 4. In March of this year, more than 300 state farmers went to Washington. A group sponsored by Alabama Farm Bureau travels to the nation's capital each year. But this year, farmers were even more determined to convince Washington that there is a crisis in America's heartland.
It's going to be a real challenge for us this year to survive. And of course, we're going to just plead with them that our food supply that could be endangered as a result of some of the foreclosures of land and people not going to be able to farm this year. I think it's more real than it's ever been.
The fact that the farmers went to Washington during House and Senate committee hearings on the 1985 Farm Bill was no coincidence. Farm leaders say the bill could make or break agriculture. Legislators are hopeful.
And we would hope we could write some farm bill that's market-oriented, reduces the cost, and gives the farmer a price instead of more credit.
Dick Fifield is Alabama Farm Bureau's representative in Washington. Fifield says Congress is already responding to farmers by proposing fewer cuts in farm programs. But Fifield says outside of the agriculture committees, there isn't a lot of sympathy.
But the majority of them don't really have a full knowledge or really an understanding, or really a lot of them don't really care a lot about the problems that farmers are having. Mm-hmm. They know they'll get the food, they get it in the supermarket.
The Reagan administration's plan is to wean farmers from federal programs, which the president says are part of the problem.
Many of the problems they face today are the result of government's involvement.
And farmers admit not all government help has done the job.
I think there were a lot of times when the farm programs were meant to be, to serve, but they wound up not doing what they should have done.
So what do farmers need?
I think that agriculture is going to have to be addressed. We can't just abandon it. We can't just say, okay, farmers, survive.
There's just two ways to go, as far as I'm concerned. The consumer had to pay the additional thing, or the government's going to have to subsidize the farmer the way he can make a profit and stay in business.
They want to compete in a marketplace, and they want to find their price in a marketplace.
But even if farmers can survive the next few years, the 1990s could bring another crisis. Who will run the family farm? We'll ask the next generation of farmers that question tomorrow night. Carrie Gordon, WSFA TV News. Farm Series Part 5. The family farm, the backbone of rural America, the pulse of the heartland. There are some problems on the farm today, but in addition to low market prices and heavy debts, the farm family is facing another possible crisis, the future. Larry McCord is a third generation farmer. His 17-year-old son, Jim, is following in his father's footsteps by raising his own livestock herd. Today, Jim works by his father's side. Tomorrow could be a different story. Will Jim be able to pick up where his dad leaves off?
We hope we can work out things where it can be passed on to him. I don't think I would encourage him. I just let him make up his own mind what he wants to do. And if he decides to farm, I'd do anything in my power to help him.
But the question of who will take over the family farm doesn't stop with the McCords.
Fewer and fewer students attending agricultural colleges these days actually plan to be farmers. Educators say it's becoming more common for ag majors to trade in the family farm for a more stable career. And here in Alabama, Auburn University is no exception.
10 years ago, 40% of these ag students would finish school and return to the farm. Educators say this year, not a one is going back. The reason? Economics.
The plight of the farmer today, the boys in trying to raise capital to start a farming operation are not willing to take that risk. They're scared, and I don't blame them.
These young men grew up watching their parents struggle to preserve the family farm they love. Farming is in their blood, yet they know they have to make a living.
I'm just from a small farm, and it's hard for us to make, well, we don't make much money, and there's really no way that me going back with two younger brothers to the same farm could make it.
For this generation, the best of both worlds may be in education. The feeling is through teaching agriculture, they can have a stable income and still stay close to the farm. Although teaching may be the immediate solution to a career, someday these young men will inherit their parents' farms and probably their problems. Looking down the road, part-time farming is the best they can hope for.
He'll probably farm it until he dies, and then we'll take it over, and it really won't be a farm there. The big farmers are really taking over, and that's where the farms are going.
It's getting harder and harder for the farmer to make a living, and all we can do is hope for the best and hope the markets come back out again next year.
Yes, the farm crisis is real in Alabama. Farmers have many problems and few solutions. Will the farm family survive into the 1990s? Only time will tell. Carrie Gordon, WSFA TV News.